Welcome everyone to this week's Colourscope. My name's Elizabeth Harper and my website's sealedwithlove.com. And I'm here with my very good friend, Carrie Samuels. Hi, Carrie.
Hi. And I'll fan myself while I say
yeah, that. We're kind of warm here. We're glowing. And if you watch my other video, you'll know why we're glowing and not sweating or perspiring. So Carrie is coming to us from San Diego. And of course, I'm on the East Coast, so it's East meets West. And Carrie's website is carriesamuels.com. And we were just talking about her new event, which is a soul salon. So she's going to have that on her website, so you'll be able to check it out. And doesn't matter where you are in the world, you can join that event. So it's going to be wonderful, and it goes on for the whole year. And
you're going to be a guest.
I'm going to be a guest next year, next April. So mark your calendars. So... Now, Carrie is a numerologist and an intuitive and a psychic and a medium. And we've come up with a way, of course, that we did last time, which is choose one of these numbers. And I'm going to show you the colors that go with it. And Carrie's going to work with the numbers. Now, the numbers, of course, are 1, 2, and 3. So just intuitively select one of those numbers, 1, 2, or 3. Now what I did was I chose a card from my Aurasoma deck for each of those colors, and those cards have numbers on them. So we're going to work with the numbers and work with the colors. So the first number, number 1, is the red card. So this is called energy, and this is the number 6. So the energy bottle with that red, of course, is the root chakra. And, you know, the 6 in the tarot link with the lovers. So red, of course, is very much about love and bringing partnerships into your life. Red energy is grounding and rooting. So when we think about this, there's an aspect of bringing relationships into your life. There's also an aspect of... if there's a relationship in your life right now, then it may be settling down. You're trying to find your roots, trying to find where you belong in that relationship. It's interesting because I'm being given the number 2 at the same time. So you may be making choices when it comes to that red energy. You know, in the tarot, there's another side to that tarot card, the lovers. It's the devil card. And the devil card is with the 2 lovers that are chained to the devil energy. So an aspect of this card is about letting go of chains, letting go of ties. So this can be relationships from your past that you may still be chained to, but you're actually not really chained to them. So it's time to let them go so you can move on. That red energy then becomes that next step, that new step. Because if it's the root chakra, it's the first color, the first energy, so it's your next step. So right now, there's an energy about relationships, there's an energy about grounding and rooting, about letting go, and about finding where you belong. All right then.
I love that. And you know, Elizabeth, the way I learned numerology was through the tarot. It's such a beautiful system. So I'm going to take what you said, because it's interesting you thought you intuited the number 2, because both the 6 energy and the 2 energy tend to give too much. They tend to think of other people first. And that red energy is very much about self and self-empowerment and taking your own self back. And one of the things that both number 6 and number 2 teach us, and we're in a 6 year right now, 2013 is a 6 universal year, so it's a theme that's running through everybody's life, is learning how to balance your needs with other people's needs. So some of those things that you were talking about letting go of, they don't necessarily mean letting go of those relationships, but within those relationships, you know, like romantic relationships or friendships, whatever it is, when you tend to think of the other person first and you tend to give away a little piece of your energy every day because you're like, well, I'm not going to say anything, or I don't really feel like doing this, or I'm not going to do this for myself because I have this obligation to this other person. And so if you chose the 6 card with this red energy with the subset of 2, this is about learning how to think of yourself first. That's the way to create harmonious relationships, which is really what that 6 energy is about. It's about creating harmonious relationships. And the way to do that is to empower yourself and think of your needs first and express your needs first so you can be a whole person within those relationships.
Cool, I love that.
Together.
They do perfectly, don't they? So now our second card that I chose is, it's called Titania. And Titania is Queen of the Fairies, and you'll see that it has turquoise on top and white on the bottom. In Orosoma, that white is clear. And this is the number 85. So with that turquoise energy being on top, that's the conscious part of you. And then that clear energy, the white energy, is the subconscious part of you. So it's like the turquoise sometimes is very creative. It can be communicative. It's also a new part of you that's opening up between the heart and the throat. So it says that some new piece of you is awakening. Now, sometimes this can be good and sometimes it can be a challenge. You know what it's like with colors, we have gifts and challenges. Turquoise is beautifully creative and it's wonderful when it comes to linking again. It's like relationship energy again, linking with soulmates particularly, because you start calling in all those people that you've known in this lifetime and previous lifetimes. But turquoise, the challenge of it is rejection. There's an energy of rejection in here, and it says, oh no, I'm not ready. So it could be that you're calling in what you most want, and then when it turns up, it's like, oh no, take it away from me, I don't want it just yet. So turquoise, of course, is very creative. So you can make up all kinds of stories right now about not being ready, not being good enough, not being in the right relationship, not having everything that you want, but you could be rejecting it yourself, whereas you've called it in. You know, whatever you want, you've called in, and you may be rejecting what you've called in. Hopefully that makes sense. That white part of it then is about letting go of tears, letting go of sadness, letting go of anything that is blocking you, that is history. It's old and it may be familial. So it may be part of your family energy and not necessarily you. You may be a beautiful bright spark, but you're carrying something within your DNA that may not be truly who you are. You're just taking something that is history from your family. So there's an aspect of this which is again about letting go and finding your true self. And just rejecting what doesn't belong to you, about you, and maybe cleansing your system. There could be tears. It could be about cleaning up your office space. Looking around here. Getting rid of things.
We're in the creative realm.
That's it. Getting rid of things that no longer reflect you. So, yeah, that's my two cents worth.
And your sixth cents. And my sixth cents. Thank you. Well, you know, it's always beautiful because you said that was the 85th card.
Yeah.
And 8 plus 5 is 13, and June is a 13 month, and of course 13 in the tarot is the death card, which
That's
is all about letting go, and July is a 13 month. So this whole year, again, a big theme of the year is letting go, because we're in the year of the water snake, and I love how that turquoise color on top is like kind of watery, and water is all about your emotions, and there's a lot of Cancerian energy throughout July, because we're in the sign of Cancer. But also now Mercury's in retrograde in Cancer, which is all about reclaiming these feelings. And sometimes reclaiming feelings that you haven't processed are shadow feelings, parts of you that you want to reject. Because I think as spiritual people, we always try to put a bright face on everything. You know, I know me and a lot of people, if there's something that you're not satisfied with your life, you know, it's nice to have gratitude, and we always have gratitude for everything, but sometimes if there's a part that you're not satisfied with, it's actually teaching you that you deserve more. It's teaching you that it's okay to have gratitude for where you are, but it's also okay to want more from where you are. And that part of you that's ready for more, I felt when you were talking that it was about complacency. Like, sometimes I think when we're grateful for our lives right now, it says it's okay to be where I am. And I think it's okay to say, I'm so grateful for who I am and where I am right now, and I want more.
Yeah.
And it's okay for me to want more. And being okay with that, and being okay with that scary for you. You know, and being okay with the parts of you that aren't okay with that, and just processing them without judgment so that you can let them go and move on. So I really feel like this Jupiter in Cancer that we're in the Mercury in retrograde in Cancer is helping us process those feelings of any kind of sadness for what we didn't have, just so we can let them go and move on and have more and be more.
Sweet. You rock.
You're the queen of the fairies.
That's right. All right, then. So our third card is lilac. It's actually called Saint Germain, and this is the number 56 bottle. So with the lilac energy, you know, this is a transformation card, but when you think about it, these have all gone. It's gone from that lilac, gone from red, the root chakra, up to the upper heart aspect, and then this is the crown chakra, above the crown chakra. So this is a story of transformation, and then you get to this point, and it's almost like, yeah, I've been there, I've seen it, I've done it, it's all behind me, I've learned that lesson, I'm not doing it again, thanks very much. I'm moving on. And that's what this is. It's like, it's over. You're moving on. It's time to move on. I don't mean you're leaving the planet. I mean, you might do if you want to. But this is, you know, with that lilac energy, you are taking that next step, but it's almost like you're going higher. It's the vibrations going higher. You're moving to a higher realm. So if we think of it in your life, like, in relationships, for instance, then it can be taking the relationship to the next level. With a home, it can be expanding your home. It could be expanding your business. It doesn't have to be all about material things, though. It can be spiritually, that you are expanding your reach from a spiritual perspective and really maybe seeing beyond where you are right now to the truth. This is a beautiful energy with Saint Germain. Saint Germain is the lilac flame of transmutation. And I've said this before, but I have this postcard that there's two snakes talking to each other, and one snake says to the other snake, "Babe, I've got you under my skin." And the one snake says, "Yeah, but you shed it every 3 weeks." So this is very much about shedding your skin and just allowing yourself to do that, because you are moving to that next level. And again, with relationships, about looking at who belongs in your life, what belongs in your life, what is your truth, and what really reflects you as well. There's a big theme with that, with these three cards, but this is the higher level of it. It's like you've moved up to that place and you totally understand everything. Yeah.
I love that, and I love that whole theme that of letting go and transformation, because we are in the year of the snake, which is about letting go and transforming. So I love the numerology, how it correlates with that. I'm sure the Aurasoma people
did it on purpose.
We're very smart with that, because 56, and I love it, it's like Five is the middle path where you're making a choice. You're like, it's in between the prime numbers, and then we step up to six, which is balance and love, which is the heart chakra. But it adds up to 11, and of course 11 is about truth and seeking enlightenment from spirit and letting go of anything that's no longer serving you, anything that's keeping you from the absolute truth of what you're born to express, and receiving your vision from spirit, receiving what your next step is from spirit. So you don't really even have to think about it. This is more about intuiting your next step and trusting that you're divinely guided, because if you're living your truth, if you're expressing who you are, if you're naturally saying, you know, this is who I am and this is who I'm going to be, and I don't care what you think about me, this is my truth, then you're going to start living your purpose. Then you're going to start living in your spirit and being inspired and inspiring other people. And I do feel that that is the essence of what that card is about. And Saint Germain, of course, is transmuting all of your fears that are keeping you from becoming all you are and just letting yourself be light. And I love the way that goes together.
I know. How about that? You think we had a confront? What's that? Confirmation? Something? Conversation?
Validating
it. That's it. Everything that, you know, I love how that happens. It's spirit is working. Yeah.
And it always happens. And two of the numbers that we were talking before, whether we should choose cards and let spirit choose or choose numbers. And I always love to let spirit choose, as you do as well. But two out of the three numbers that I thought to talk about were what we chose anyway.
That's so, it. Isn't that perfect? Go. Cool. Mm-hmm. So, thank you, Carrie, for being with us this week.
For all you do.
And Carrie, of course, you know, she's online and she's in San Diego in person as well. So if you're in California, you can check her out and work with her. And her website's carriesamuels.com. And of course, my website's sealedwithlove.com. So do check me out too. So we will see you very soon next week. Do share the color scope with your friends and lots of colorish's blessings. Thank you. Bye.
Bye. Lots of love.